Sometimes these were isolated stations, and other times they comprised entire cities. We are going to have to fly to a higher altitude for this. I need to show you. Hold on tight now and keep your eyes open. Look. The sole existence, let alone construction of these star structures, is almost beyond our comprehension. As you saw, they are found everywhere across our realm, with undeviating geometric consistency. A wondrous impossibility. Perhaps they had some kind of technology that allowed them to view huge areas of land from above while planning and building. They were never forts. That is a fairy tale invented by our controllers. The stunning geometric precision and symmetry of the star structures would most likely have functioned to enhance the power of the generators and to etherize the water, or turn the water into living, energized water. We can see from comparing some of these ruined sites, and some left a little more intact, that water would have been present throughout the structure. Before the controllers destroyed and drained most of these structures, they were full of water. They were connected to rivers and canals and the oceans. They were a key component of the entire power grid. The star structures are fractals of symmetrical geometry, just like many of the ceilings of these huge energy generators. And, like the acoustic cavity magnetrons and resonators, the symmetrical sharp diagonal walls would have caused the ions to perpetually vibrate. Old plans and illustrations, which have no doubt been edited or manipulated in some way or another, offer suggestion as to how complex, integrated, and essential the star geometry was to the entire grid. Look at Paris here. It isn't obvious at first glance, but upon closer inspection, we come to realize that the entirety of Paris was itself a star station, or a star city. And like with everything else constructed in the old world, these structures were at once functional and a celebration of the source of their innovation. Look closer at the star geometry here. Can you see the resemblance? The snowflake. Do you remember what happened in Masaru Emoto's experiment on water? Ethereal vibration expressing itself through water's molecular structure. Those of the old world had perfected this science. They knew the key to releasing electromagnetism's potential was through sound and water. Just imagine what they were able to achieve. Sound, vibration, and frequency was just as integral to the success of their technology as water was. Those of the old world did not hide their adoration for sound. Traces of this love for sound are everywhere. These structures were literally instruments of power. Or as the so-called Goethe put it so succinctly elsewhere, music is liquid architecture. Architecture is frozen music.